Good Thursday evening, everyone. This is our weather map showing our weather alerts, watches and warnings, tornado watches covering North Texas, Southeast Oklahoma, Southern Arkansas, Northern Louisiana. That's the yellow shaded counties you see there. A very, very, very active night for those folks. If you know anyone who lives in East Texas, Southeast Oklahoma, Arkansas, Louisiana, Mississippi, West Tennessee, make sure they're paying attention to the weather tonight. A very rough night ahead for those folks, and these nighttime storms are more dangerous than all because you can't see. Flash flood watches are the dark green shaded counties from northern Arkansas up through Ohio. And then that odd tan colored shading on Kentucky and Tennessee. For the first time in my meteorological career, the entire state of Tennessee is under a high wind warning. Some meteorologists have never seen anything like this, like an entire state. Especially like Tennessee, that stretches so far from west to east, being under a high wind warning. Now, we've had high wind warnings here on the plateau before, but it's been many years ago. Normally, we'll get these for, when I've seen them, what I can recall is for tropical events that have come up over the top of us and still had some strong winds. But this is quite bizarre. So, we're calling this about a once in a 30-year event. The area of low pressure that's deepening over the southern plains will move northeast, and at one point, it could have the pressure of about a Cat 1 hurricane. So this is a very unique situation. As Nashville's National Weather Service stated this evening, this is a unique situation and we should treat it as such. So very strong winds for Friday. So regardless of if we get any severe thunderstorms, this is enough to be a headline. So this would be enough for us to cancel schools, to be weather aware, just for the southerly winds that are going to be sustained at 20 to 30 miles an hour, gusting to 60, maybe higher. So we need to be very, very, very weather aware for these high winds that will be starting up later tonight and being with us throughout the day on Friday. So prepare for power outages, prepare for the possibility for long duration power outages. Just depends on how many trees come down on the lines as to how long you could be without power. This is the weather map for tomorrow, showing all the strong to severe thunderstorms in the southeast, flash flood risk to our north. Our flash flood risk has decreased. As you can see on my concern chart here, I did decrease the threat for flash flooding, so that's the good news. Threat time frame remains 10 to 2. That's what I said this morning and last night. That's what I'm sticking with. Very high straight line wind threat. That's the highest risk I've ever put on straight line winds. Hail threat, very low. Tornado threat, medium, borderline high. So quick spin up tornadoes in this line that's going to come through. Could see some storms out ahead of the line. That doesn't look as favorable, but definitely along that line, there could be some spin up tornadoes. There's so much wind energy. It's not going to take, tomorrow's one of those days where when storms start coming through, you need to treat them all as tornado warnings because they're going to have the winds of a weak tornado if they can put those down to the surface. The winds just up off the surface tomorrow could be in excess of 100 miles an hour. So if any of those storms can put down some of those winds, we could see wind gusts 70, 80 miles an hour with some of these storms. Some of the showers could even produce damaging winds. So, and like I said, we could have damaging winds with no rain at all falling from the sky just because of the strong southerly winds that'll be blowing in here. So again, charge up your phones, charge up your tablets, charge up whatever you need to charge up because you're still going to need to get weather warnings tomorrow, even if the wind knocks your power out before the storms get here. So don't be caught without anything to get your information off of because you didn't charge everything up and get ready. I've got a little battery pack. I keep all kinds of battery packs charged up. I'm ready to go when it comes to the power going out, except for my comfort level. I do not like being without power. But anyway, so let's make precautions for that. This is the hourly weather. I do these charts myself. A lot of your apps, those hourly weather charts and stuff, are computer generated and have little to no human oversight. I spend a lot of time on these things because these are difficult. So, see a little uptick in showers around 9 to 10 p.m., 50% chance. Doesn't mean everybody's going to get them, but there will be some showers around. Ticks down a little bit in the 11 o'clock to 1 o'clock a.m. time frame before we shoot back up to pretty good rain chances from about 2 a.m. on into about 4 a.m. That's the warm front lifting north. Now it could spark off some thunderstorms, so don't be surprised if you hear some thunder tonight. And don't let me remind you that the thunderstorms along warm fronts produce very loud thunder because of the way the temperature profile is through the atmosphere. So it could be very loud thunder if you get some. Those storms are expected to remain below severe limits. Now I'm overly cautious and I leave my weather radio on all the time. So you might still want to do that. There was a time when we were worried about tonight's storms, But the latest data that's come in and from the weather balloon launch at Nashville this evening, our atmosphere is not very unstable tonight. So it looks like those storms will just won't have the energy available to become severe. Now, our rain chances drop down from about the 5 a.m. to 8 a.m. hour, start ticking back up a little bit around mid-morning, and then the front comes through. So this is the front that we're worried about producing severe weather. Now, you see those rain chances tick up to 90% around midday, but keep in mind that line could slow down or speed up. So give or take an hour or two, you know, with that line. That's why the threat time frame is from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Now, this is what's extremely interesting. This is the hourly wind reports, okay? So, like the previous chart, starts at 8 o'clock in the morning, ends at 8 o'clock tomorrow evening. Winds around 20 miles an hour by just after mid-morning, getting closer to the noon hour, and then ticking up. Look at how dramatically things start to, that's after midnight, I'm sorry, that it starts ticking up to 20 miles an hour, 25 miles an hour. So, by sunrise, we're at 31 miles an hour, if you see there at 5 o'clock a.m., 40 miles per hour by 7 a.m., and then get up to 50 miles an hour by 10, and then in excess of 60 miles an hour in the afternoon. So some very, very, very strong winds coming through tomorrow. So be as prepared as you can. Know where your safe place is for if the storms come through. Got your helmets ready for your head protection. Got your shoes on in case there's broken glass. You don't want to walk on bare feet. Just know your plan. Get to the middle of your house, interior room away from windows, lowest level of your home. If kids in the house are scared of storms, take something for them to be preoccupied with, play a game, do something, practice that plan and practice it. The more everybody's prepared, the less scared everyone will be. And as you all know, I will be watching everything so very closely. I was supposed to go visit some schools tomorrow. Those have, of course, been rescheduled. I rescheduled those earlier today because I had a feeling things were going to get a little bumpy. I'll keep an eye on things. You all just keep it right here to meteorologistmark.com.